Good morning, one and all present over here. Myself, Supriya Gavai, student of Sri D.D. Vispute College of Pharmacy and Research Center, M.Pharm first year, Pharmaceutics Department. Due to the COVID-19 pandemic, I am pre-recording this video. The topic of my presentation is the novel drug delivery system, which includes NewsOM and Transferosome. So now let's start the presentation. Contents include introduction, definition and structure, advantages, components of NewsOM and Transferosome, what are the characteristics, factors affecting and difference between NewsOM and Transferosome, method of preparation for both, application, conclusion and references. Now, novel drug delivery system means a new drug delivery system which refers to the approaches, formulation, technologies and system for transporting the pharmaceutical compound in the body safely to achieve its desired therapeutic effect. Novel drug delivery system modifies the drug release profile, which is beneficial for improving the product efficacy and patient convenience as well as compliance. Examples of novel drug delivery system includes liposomes, neosomes, nanoparticle, microspheres, monoclonal antibodies, transferosome, virosome, etc. Novel drug delivery system is a system in which the medication or the active ingredient is needed to be encapsulated in a vesicle, a bilayer vesicle of non-ionic surface active agent. Although NewsOM and transferosomes are structurally similar to liposome, but they offer several advantages over liposomes. Now, speaking about definition and structure of NewsOMs. What are NewsOMs? They are non-ionic surfactant vesicles obtained on hydration process of synthetic non-ionic surfactant with or without the incorporation of cholesterol or other lipids. In the structure of NewsOM, we can see a bilayer in which the polar head are facing away from each other while the polar tails are facing towards each other. There is an aqueous compartment in which the aqueous drug is to be incorporated or the hydrophilic drug is to be incorporated. Lipophilic drugs are to be incorporated in the bilayer membrane. Now, transferosomes. These are specially designed vesicular systems consisting of at least one inner aqueous compartment enclosed by the lipid vesicles. Transferosomes are highly deformable and to go through the pores of much smaller size than their own. In the structure of transferosomes, there is a hydrophobic region, a hydrophilic region, and a bilayer softening compound. Hydrophobic region is for water insoluble drug incorporation. Hydrophilic region is for water soluble drug incorporation. Now the components of NewsOM and transferosome. Components of NewsOM include non-ionic surfactant, cholesterol and solvent. A number of non-ionic surfactant can be used to prepare NewsOM such as polyglycerol alkyl ether, crown ether, esters, etc. Cholesterol provide rigidity and maintain the proper shape of NewsOMs. NewsOM can entrap both hydrophilic as well as lipophilic drug, either in the aqueous or in vesicular membrane. NewsOMs and liposome are equal active in drug delivery potential. NewsOMs are preferred over liposome because NewsOM exhibit a higher chemical stability, better entrapment efficiency and improved bioavailability, and they are more economical as considered than liposomes. Now, component of transferosome include surfactant, phospholipid and solvent. Speaking about surfactant, they are bilayer softening compounds and also provide flexibility, which includes Twin-80, Span-80, sodium cholate. Phospholipid include soya phosphatidylcholine, egg phosphatidylcholine. Phospholipids as lipid forming components they are used, and solvent includes ethanol and methanol. Transferosome can overcome the skin penetration difficulty by squeezing themselves along the intracellular sealing lipids of stratum corneum. There are two possible mechanisms of transferosome of penetration into the skin. The first one is transferosome act as a drug vector remaining intact after entering into the skin. And second one is transferosome act as a penetration enhancer by disrupting the highly organized intracellular lipid from stratum corneum and therefore the drug molecule can penetrate across the stratum corneum easily. Now, what are the advantages of neosome and why they are preferred over liposomes? Targeted drug delivery can be achieved using neosomes. Neosomes are made up from uncharged chain, single chain surfactant molecules. Also, neosome increases the oral bioavailability of poorly soluble drug and also enhance their skin penetrability when they are applied topically. Ingredients like polyglycerol alkyl ethers are also chemically stable. Neosomes do not require any special storage condition or handling, which is mandatory in liposomes. Reduced dose is also required to get the desired therapeutic effect. This can be achieved by neosomes. Also, neosomes are not as expensive as compared to liposomes. Next is advantages of transferosomes. Also here, targeted drug delivery can be achieved using transferosomes. Transferosomes are more stable as compared to liposomes. They have increased skin penetrability of topical drugs. They also protect the encapsulated drug from metabolic degradation. As transferosomes have highly deformable structure, which gives them a penetration of intact vesicles. Transferosomes are suitable for both lipophilic as well as hydrophilic drugs of low and high molecular weight. They are biocompatible and biodegradable as they are made up from natural phospholipids, which is similar to liposomes. Now, method of preparation for neosome include handshaking method, sonication method, ether injection method, multiple membrane extrusion method, aqueous dispersion method. Recently advanced technique uses bubble method, formation of neosome from proneosome and microfluidization. Now, let's see the handshaking method. Handshaking method, also known as thin film hydration method. In this method, the surfactant and cholesterol mixture is added in a round bottom flask and dissolved in volatile organic solvent. With the help of handshaking or by the rotary flash evaporator, the organic solvent is removed at room temperature, which leads to the formation of a thin film on the wall of the flask. Now, the dried thin film can be rehydrated by using the aqueous phase at 50 to 60 degrees Celsius with gentle agitation. This process leads to the formation of multilaminar neosomal dispersion, which can be later separated. Now, the next one is sonication method. In this method, the drug is added in the aqueous phase and then the surfactant or cholesterol is added in the aqueous phase. In the second step, the mixture is probe sonicated for 3 minutes at 60 degrees Celsius using a titanium probe. The neosomes are formed by this method and their size is not smaller than 100 nanometer. In this method, the lipid solution in diethyl ether is slowly injected into warm water, that is aqueous solution, of the material to be encapsulated using the syringe type infusion pump, that is 14 gauge needle, at 55 to 65 degrees Celsius under the reduced pressure. Vaporization of ether leads to the formation of single layer vesicles. The diameter of vesicle ranges from 50 to 1000 nanometer. Now, talking about multiple membrane extrusion method. In this method, the mixture of surfactant, cholesterol, diacetyl phosphate in chloroform is made into a thin film by evaporation. This film is hydrated with the aqueous drug solution and the resultant suspension is extruded through the polycarbonate membrane. It is a good method for controlling the neosome size. Recently advanced technique for neosome preparation. The first is bubble method. It is a novel technique and a one-step preparation of neosome and liposome without the use of organic solvent. In this technique, RBF as a bubbling unit with three neck is used. Water cooled reflux, thermometer and nitrogen supply are done through first, second and third neck. The cholesterol and surfactant dispersed in the buffer pH 7.4 at 40 degrees Celsius. Above, the dispersion is homogenized for 15 seconds and then bubbled with nitrogen gas at 70 degrees Celsius to get the neosomes. Now, method of preparation for transferosome. Method of preparation for transferosome is kind of similar to the method of preparation of neosome. That is the thin film hydration method. It involves two steps. The first step is preparation of hydration of thin film, and the second step is sonication. A thin film is prepared from the mixture of phospholipid and surfactant by dissolving it in a volatile organic solvent. The organic solvent is then evaporated. The final traces of the solvent were removed under the vacuum for overnight. The prepared thin film is then hydrated with the buffer by the rotation at 60 rpm in the rotary flash evaporator for 1 hour. The resulting vesicles are swollen for 2 hours at room temperature. In the next sonication step, to prepare the small size vesicles, they are sonicated at room temperature or 50 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes using a bath sonicator or using a probe sonicator, and the sonicated vessels were later homogenized. The next is characterization of neosome and transferosome. It includes entrapment efficiency of drug, vesicle morphology, and in vitro release. Entrapment efficiency of drug is determined by the complete vesicle disruption and analyzing the resultant solution by appropriate assay method. The formula for percent entrapment efficiency is amount entrapped upon total amount or total drug into 100. Entrapment efficiency mainly depends upon the method of preparation. After preparing the neosomal dispersion, the unentrapped drug is separated via gel filtration, dialysis, centrifugation, etc. The next is vesicle morphology. It includes size of neosome, bilayer formation, number of lamellae, and membrane rigidity. Size of neosome: the shape of neosome is assumed to be spherical, and the mean diameter is determined by TEM, that is transmission electron microscopy or freeze fracture electron microscopy. Bilayer formation: assembly of non-ionic surfactant to form the bilayer vesicles is characterized by light microscopy. Membrane rigidity and number of lamellae, it is determined by NMR spectroscopy. Now for in vitro release, a procedure is followed. In that procedure, a dialysis sack is washed and soaked in distilled water. The vesicle in the suspension is pipetted into the bag made of tubing and sealed. The bag containing the vesicle is placed in 200 ml buffer solution in a 250 ml beaker with constant shaking at 25 to 37 degrees Celsius. At various time interval, the buffer is analyzed for the drug content by an appropriate assay method. Now the factors affecting neosome and transferosome include drug. The entrapment of the drug in neosome and transferosome increases its vesicle size. Amount and type of surfactant. Size of neosome and transferosome increases with increase in HLB of surfactant. The method of preparation: mostly handshaking method is used for the preparation of neosome and transferosome, which gives vesicle with greater diameter as compared to the ether injection method. Then cholesterol content. Cholesterol content in the neosome and transferosome increases its diameter and entrapment efficiency. Temperature on hydration. Hydration temperature increases the shape and size of neosome and transferosome. Now the next one is the difference between neosome and transferosome. These are the two images, the SEM images of neosome and transferosome. The major difference between neosome and transferosome is that transferosomes are highly deformable in nature, which helps them for the better penetration. They can penetrate better as compared to neosome as well as liposome. The flexibility of transferosome membrane reduces the risk of complete vesicle rupture in the skin and allows the transferosome to follow the natural water gradient across the epidermis when applied under non-occlusive conditions. Now the next is marketed products. Lancome and L'Oreal has entered into the market with different cosmetic products which are based upon the neosomal formulation, which includes different foundation cream, different lotion, different anti-aging cream, etc. Now various companies have also started to launch the neosomal or transferosomal gel for pain relief. Flexicure is the example of transferosomal gel. Nowadays various companies are using neosomal or transferosomal drug delivery system as they have greater penetrability and desired therapeutic effect with less side effect. The next are application of neosomes. There are number of applications of neosomes, which includes drug targeting, leishmaniasis, antineoplastic treatment, transdermal drug delivery of peptide drugs, anti-infective agents, immunological application of neosomes, neosomes as carrier for hemoglobin, sustained release of the drug, anti-cancer drug, anti-inflammatory agent, diagnostic purpose, ophthalmic drug delivery, neosomes in oral drug delivery, pulmonary drug delivery, treatment of HIV/AIDS, cosmetics and skincare application, etc. Now, in drug targeting, it is one of the most useful aspect of neosomes as their ability to target the drug. Neosome can be used to target the drug in reticoendothelial cells. Now, leishmaniasis. It is a disease in which the parasites eat the cells of liver and spleen. Neosome can be used for targeting the drugs in the treatment of these diseases without any side effects and allowing greater efficiency. Now, transdermal drug delivery. The slow penetration of the drug through skin is the major drawback of transdermal route. So, neosomes are used for better penetration and it causes less side effect. Antineoplastic treatment. Most of the antineoplastic drug causes severe side effect. Neosomal entrapment can increase the half-life of the drug and prolong its circulation, alter its metabolism, thus decreasing the side effect of the drug. Delivery of peptide drugs. Then, delivery of neosomes in oral drug delivery. Neosomal formulations of oral drug delivery show increased gastrointestinal absorption of drug, protection from proteolytic enzyme, and good stability. Then, cosmetics and skincare applications. Applications of neosome in cosmetics and skincare has following advantages. It has increased stability for entrapped drug, improved bioavailability of poorly absorbed ingredients, and enhanced skin penetration. Neosomal drug delivery system can be administered orally via ocular drug delivery system, transdermal delivery, and via vaginal route. The next is application of transferosomes. There are a number of application of transferosome. They are used as a drug carrier, transport of large molecular weight compound, delivery of anti-cancer drug, delivery of anesthetics, delivery of herbal drug, delivery of corticosteroid, and for controlled release. Used as a carrier, transferosome have been widely used as a carrier for the transport of protein and other peptides. Transferosome possess ultra deformable nature, which can be utilized for the transport and targeting of proteins and peptides. Transferosome offer transdermal route of administration of protein and peptide, which is better than the parenteral delivery of these bioactive molecules. Then next is controlled release drug delivery. Transferosome have the ability for controlled release of administered drug and increasing the stability of liable drug due to the incorporation of phospholipid. Then delivery. Anesthetic delivery. Application of anesthetics in the suspension of transferosome induces a topical anesthesia under certain suitable condition within 10 minutes. As compared to the subcutaneous bolus injection, the effect of transferosomal anesthesia lasts longer. Then delivery of herbal drug. Ultra-deformable vesicular system has the ability to penetrate deeper into skin toward the stratum corneum and is able to transport the nutrients via dermal route for functioning of the skin. It is reported that capsaicin transferosome show better absorption than that of capsaicin pure. Transferosomes are also used for the insulin delivery. Subcutaneous route is commonly used for the delivery of insulin, which is not convenient for most of the patient. Preparation of transferosulin, that is insulin transferosomes, by encapsulating the insulin into the deformable vesicle system nearly conquers all the problems in relation to the delivery of insulin. Conclusion. The concept of incorporating drug into neosome for better targeting of drug at appropriate tissue destination. Neosomes are thought to be better candidates than the other drug delivery system. Various type of drug has been possibly delivered using neosome, like targeting, ophthalmic, topical, etc. Now, transferosomes are specially optimized particles or vesicles which can respond to external stress by rapidly, energetically, inexpensive and shape transformation. Such highly deformable particles can be used across the biological penetrability barrier such as skin. So these are my references for the presentation. Thank you.